Let's review CVP analysis. If you'll turn into your lecture notes, we'll get started. The first problem shows that the employees of Mobile Sun Lotion Company roam the beaches with a tank of premium suntan lotion strapped on their backs. For a $2 charge, the employees will spray sunbathers with suntan lotion. Last year, Mobile sprayed 250,000 customers and incurred $175,000 in total variable costs and $50,000 in total fixed costs. Assuming that this activity is within the relevant range, what would Mobile's total contribution margin have been last year if only 240,000 customers were sprayed? So we have a decrease in volume, and in order to find the contribution margin, we will need to first find our cost structure. We were given that last year, when Mobile sprayed 250,000 customers, they incurred $175,000 in total variable costs and $50,000 in total fixed costs. For the variable costs, we need to find the variable cost per unit. Last year, it was $175,000, and we had 250,000 customers. That computes to $70 per customer, or 70 cents per customer, or 70 cents per unit of service. Total fixed costs were given to be $50,000, and fixed costs in total will remain at $50,000, since this is within our relevant range. The new contribution margin will be sales, 240,000 customers times $2 per customer, or $480,000, minus variable costs, 240,000 customers times 70 cents, or $168,000, leaving a contribution margin of $312,000. Notice that the sales and variable costs will be lower when activity is lower, as is demonstrated here. What is the break-even point for the company? Well, now that we have computed the cost structure, we can solve for the break-even point fairly easily. 2x is sales, 0.7x is the total variable cost, $50,000 is the total fixed cost, and at the break-even point, we will have zero profit. When we do our math, we get $1.30x equal $50,000 plus zero, or x equal $50,000 plus zero divided by $1.30. This gives us a break-even point of 38,462 units. The shortcut would have been to just simply take the total fixed cost of $50,000 plus zero profit divided by the $1.30 contribution margin per unit. What was the margin of safety last year? Since we were basing this on actual sales for last year, we can take actual sales minus break-even sales to get the margin of safety. Actual sales were 250,000 units of service. Break-even sales were 38,462. That computes to a margin of safety of 211,538 units of service. So a fairly significant margin of safety for this company. What effect would a decrease in the variable cost per unit due to the break-even point and the contribution margin ratio? Well, anytime you have a decrease in cost, whether it's variable or fixed, you're going to have a lower break-even point. The contribution margin ratio, with lower variable costs, the contribution margin would be higher, resulting in a higher contribution margin ratio. Now, if it's difficult for you to just think this out in your head, you can make up some numbers. For example, we could assume that the variable cost per unit decreased from 70 cents per unit to 60 cents per unit. This would fall in line with a decrease in the variable cost per unit, as stated. The break-even point would be 2x minus 0.6x minus $50,000, or 35,715 units of service. You can compare this to what it had been previously, which was 38,642 units of service. So this is, in fact, a decrease. The contribution margin ratio. The contribution margin now is $1.40, 2 minus 0.6, divided by 2, or 70%. It had been 65% if you crunch those numbers. So this just proves that it will result in an increase in the contribution margin ratio. What effect would a decrease in total fixed costs have on the break-even point and the contribution margin ratio? Well, again, any decrease in cost is going to decrease your break-even point. The contribution margin ratio would be sales minus variable cost divided by sales. So fixed costs really have nothing to do with that formula. So it would have no effect. Now again, here you could make up some numbers and decrease total fixed costs to something like $40,000 as opposed to the original $50,000 and crunch the numbers and see that this is, in fact, the effect of this. So from this problem, we reviewed the basics behind CVP analysis, but you can see with the low level of fixed cost with the mobile sun lotion company, they have a very low break-even point and therefore a high margin of safety since they had a significant level of sales in the prior year.